الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي علم بالقلم، علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم، والصلاة والسلام على سيد العرب والعجم، صلى الله عليه وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، وعلى أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين، وعلى أصحابه غر الميامين، وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. يقول الله عز وجل في كتابه بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هل أتاك حديث موسى إذ ناداه ربه بالوادي المقدس طوى، اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى، فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى، فأراه الآية الكبرى فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى، فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى، فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى، إن في ذلك العبرة لمن يخشى. Alhamdulillah, we are in the beginning of a new Islamic year in this month of Muharram. So may Allah Ta'ala forgive our sins for the previous year, and may Allah Ta'ala fill this year with blessing and prosperity. Ameen. This month, Muharram, holds a lot of importance in the eyes of Allah, in our deen, and these coming days are very special in the eyes of Allah. What gives these days its importance? So today, inshallah, we will be talking about this today. Fir'aun was a man whom Allah Ta'ala had given a lot of wealth and a lot of power and might, a lot of respect. Things would happen at the snap of his fingers. And this money and power that Allah Ta'ala gave Fir'aun, this started to get to Fir'aun's head. And it got to him so much so that he started making all of these false claims. To the point where Allah Ta'ala says, Fir'aun used to say to his people, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. Fir'aun would say to his people, I am your Allah. Because Fir'aun would say to them, I am so rich, I am so powerful, I have all of the qualities that you say God has. So I am Allah. So he told people to start worshipping him. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, Fir'aun would gather all of his people in Egypt, and he would say to them, أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأْ مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرِي. Fir'aun used to gather his people and say, O my people, I don't know of any God for you to worship besides me. This was Fir'aun. And Fir'aun used to say, Ya Qawm, O my people, أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرِ. O people, don't you see that I own Egypt? وَهَذِهِ الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي. O my people, don't you see that all of these rivers, they flow beneath me, they are under my control. أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Fir'aun used to say, don't you see all of this? أَمْ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ هَذَا الَّذِي هُوَ مَهِينَ. Fir'aun used to say, am I not better than this disgraced person? Na'udhu billah, talking about Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. وَلَا يَكَاتُ يُبِينَ. Am I not better than this man who can't even speak properly? Musa alayhi salatu wasalam had a stutter in his tongue. He could not speak properly. The dua of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam is very famous. رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِّن لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam asked Allah Ta'ala, Ya Allah, open this knot in my tongue so that they can understand my speech. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam could not speak properly. So Fir'aun used to say, am I not better than this Musa? La yakadu yubin. He cannot even speak properly. Now, it's been the nizam of Allah. It's always been the system of Allah that whenever there is batil, whenever there is wrong, there is always right to oppose it. Whenever there is injustice, there is always justice. It doesn't necessarily come when we want it or expect it to come. But when it comes, like Allah Ta'ala says, قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ. That when the haq does come, then the batil goes away. Where there was Abu Lahab and Abu Jahl, people like that, there was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where there was Habil, one son of Prophet Adam, then there was Qabil, the other son. Where there is Fir'aun, there is a Musa. And there has always been Fir'auns, and there always will be Fir'auns in every time and every zamana. In every time and era, there are Fara'een, And in every time and era, there are Musa. And may Allah Ta'ala make us among those who walk the path of Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam's story and Fir'aun's story is no stranger. Allah Ta'ala discusses Prophet Musa's story in the Quran so much so that the Mufassirin used to say, "Kad al Quran an yakuna Musa." The Mufassirin used to say it was so close that the whole Quran be just about the story of Musa. Allah Ta'ala discusses how Prophet Musa was born, and how Prophet Musa fled, and how Prophet Musa got married. All of these stories in detail Allah Ta'ala discusses. Okay. Now, Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was sent at a time when Fir'aun was at his peak. When Fir'aun was at his peak of among Jababira. Fir'aun was among those who are very zalim, heartless. We know the stories, we don't have time to go into all of them now. Now, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was a staunch enemy of Fir'aun. Fir'aun was a staunch enemy of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Fir'aun was getting very tired of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, because Prophet Musa gradually started to take people away from worshipping Musa to Fir'aun to worshipping Allah. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam gradually got people to start worshipping Allah Ta'ala. So this really made Fir'aun very mad, that who is this person coming and being a distraction in what I'm trying to do? Especially after Musa alayhi salatu wasalam won the battle with the magicians, a lot of people accepted the deen of Prophet Musa, because the magicians of Fir'aun themselves accepted the deen of Musa. So this made Fir'aun very, very mad. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam had enough of Fir'aun. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam made a dua. He said, "Rabbana innaka ataita Fir'auna wa mala'ahu zinatan wa amwalan fil hayati ad-dunya." Musa alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Ya Allah, you have given Fir'aun and his people zinatan wa amwal. You have given them so much wealth and so much blessings of this dunya. Rabbana liyudillu an sabilik." Ya Allah, Fir'aun and his people, they're just disobeying you, and you keep blessing them with more and more. Rabbana tmis ala amwalihim. Ya Allah, wipe out their money. Washdud ala qulubihim. Ya Allah, seize their hearts. He made dua now against Fir'aun and the followers. فَلَا يُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى يَرَوُوا الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمِ. Now, after Musa alayhi salatu wasalam made this dua against Fir'aun, Allah Ta'ala said, "O Musa, ujibat da'watukuma." O Musa, I have accepted your dua. Allah gave Musa alayhi salatu wasalam permission to migrate so they can flee the persecution. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and the Muslims, they left Egypt to go to Syria to flee the persecution of Fir'aun and his people. When Fir'aun found out that Musa is leaving with all of his people, the believers, this made Fir'aun extremely mad. So Allah Ta'ala told Musa, "O Musa, wa ohayna ila Musa an asri bi ibadi innakum muttaba'un." Allah Ta'ala says, "We told Musa, O Musa, leave for Syria at night time. Travel at night. Innakum muttaba'un. Fir'aun will follow you." So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam left at night, and he is traveling to Syria, and Fir'aun finds out, and Fir'aun became extremely angry. So Allah Ta'ala says, Fir'aun came and gathered an army. And the Mufassirin mentioned this was an army of over 100,000. 100,000. And they started following the path of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. فَأَتْبَعُوهُمْ مُشْرِقِينَ. Now, Fir'aun is traveling at night time. Musa is traveling at night time. By sunrise, Fir'aun had caught up to Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah Ta'ala says, فَأَتْبَعُوهُمْ مُشْرِقِينَ فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَىٰ إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. When Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and his army at sunrise saw that now in front of them there is the Red Sea, and behind them is the army of Fir'aun, the army of Musa said, إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. Oh Musa, where have you brought us? We're stuck. Behind us, Fir'aun is ready to kill us. In front of us is the Red Sea. We are here with our families. How are we going to cross the Red Sea? Meaning we're done. إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. We have been caught. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam said, قَالَ كَلَّا إِنَّ مَعْيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam said, كَلَّا means No, never, we are not caught. Inna ma'aya rabbi sayahdeen, my Allah is with me, He will show me the way. So Allah Ta'ala says, we told Musa, O Musa, idrib bi'asaka al-bahr. O Musa, take your staff, the famous staff of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, take your staff and strike it on the water. فَانْفَلَقَ فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. Now Bani Israel, the people who came with Prophet Musa, they were in 12 tribes. They had 12 tribes. The people of Musa were in 12 qabail. So when Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam struck the Red Sea, Allah Ta'ala made it such that Allah made 12 paths in the ocean. So each qabila, each tribe could walk their own path crossing the ocean. Now how were these paths in the ocean? Allah Ta'ala describes this in detail. Allah Ta'ala says, فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. Look, if there is a path in the middle of the ocean, where is the water going to go? If the water goes to the right or the left, then there's only one path. How will there be 12 paths? Where will the water go? Did it go beneath the earth? Where did it go? Allah Ta'ala says that the water, Allah Ta'ala made it go up. It was as if there were mountains, walls the size of mountains of just water. Just imagine this in your head. When He struck the water, all of the water went up and there was a path in between the water. And there were 12 paths like this. So each tribe could walk their own path. And obviously the water has been there for thousands of years. You would think that it would be really slippery down there when they're crossing. Allah Ta'ala says, اِضْرِبْ لَهُمْ طَرِيقًا فِي الْبَحْرِ يَبَسَى. That the path we made in the middle of the ocean was a dry path. A dry path. And then Allah said, Oh Musa, لَا تَخَافُ دَرَكُمْ وَلَا تَخْشَى. Oh Musa, don't worry. Fir'aun will not be able to catch you. And Oh Musa, don't fear anything. Allah Ta'ala gave Musa alayhi salatu wasalam some ease that don't worry, لَا تَخَافُ دَرَكَ. Fir'aun won't be able to get to you. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and his army, they crossed through these 12 paths in the ocean. As they were nearing the end of the path, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam thought something. He thought that when we all get out the water, let me take my staff and hit the ground again so all of the water can come back. Because he was thinking, if Fir'aun crosses the same path, then he's going to catch up to us again. So let me strike the ground so all of the water can come down so he doesn't get a chance to get to us. As soon as Musa alayhi salatu wasalam thought of this, Allah Ta'ala said, اُتْرُكِ الْبَحْرَ رَهْوَى. Oh Musa, leave the water as I made it right now. Don't strike it with your staff. Leave it with the paths there. And why did Allah say that? Allah says, إِنَّهُمْ جُنْدٌ مُغْرَقُونَ. Now Fir'aun and his army will drown. Now he's had enough. So Fir'aun came and he saw that there are 12 paths in the midst of an ocean. And instead of, now this is ghurur, this is what takabbur does to you. What should have happened was that Fir'aun sees that a Nabi of Allah just performed a miracle. Let me stop and accept his deen. This should have happened. He should have said, wow, you know, obviously he must be a prophet. Look what he's done. But when you have that much ghurur, that much pride and arrogance, you can't see anything. It doesn't matter what sign of Allah you see, you'll see it, but you won't see it. You understand? You will have basarat, no basirat. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, سَأَصْرِفُ عَنْ آيَاتِيَ الَّذِينَ يَتَكَبَّرُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. That those who have pride, I will turn my signs away from them. And there was no one more arrogant than Fir'aun at that time. Imagine, he's so arrogant that he claimed to be God. So Fir'aun comes to the sea, and the Mufassirin mentioned that when he got there, and he was with his people, instead of saying, let's stop and accept the deen of Musa, he said to his army, look what I've done for you. Look, I've made 12 paths in the ocean, let's go. So as soon as Fir'aun and his army all got inside the water, and there was not one person left behind, when they were all in the water, Allah Ta'ala said, أَغْرَقْنَا الْآخَرِينَ. We brought all of the water back down. And every single person in that army, including Fir'aun, drowned. Now, there are some more details to the story. The story is not the point. Allah Ta'ala says, in this whole story, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَعِبْرَةً لِمَنْ يَخْشَى. Allah Ta'ala mentions this story in the Quran, and then Allah says, in this incident, there is a ibrah. There is some lesson for those who fear Allah. What is the lesson? Look, Allah Ta'ala had given Fir'aun wealth. Allah Ta'ala had given Fir'aun power and might, respect. Anything that a person could wish for in this world, Allah had given Fir'aun. Allah Ta'ala had given Qarun. Allah Ta'ala had given Haman. Allah Ta'ala had given these people. Allah says in the Quran that when people used to see Qarun and Fir'aun, they used to say, Ya layta lana mithla ma uti. How we wish we could be given the same thing they have. Imagine you see a person, he's sitting on a throne of gold and he has all of these things at his fingertips. This is what everyone works for, this is what people want. Allah Ta'ala had given him all of this. But when all of this got to his head, then this was the reason for his drowning. Allah Ta'ala has also given us these things. Allah Ta'ala has also given us wealth. Allah has also given us respect. Allah has given us the same things. Allah Ta'ala is reminding us that just because you have a lot of wealth doesn't mean you can talk to people the way you want. Just because you have a lot of money doesn't give you the right to speak to people the way you want. Just because you have a lot of respect in your workplaces doesn't mean you go around demanding the same respect from everyone else in this dunya. Sometimes, and the reason these things I'm mentioning here, these are the reasons for a lot of divorces happening. Okay, I'm speaking from your community. A person is well respected in their workplace. When they come home, they might not get that same respect that they have. And that is a reason for a huge fight happening. How come you are not respecting me the way I am respected elsewhere? Ya Allah, who are you to ask for such respect? Or who am I to ask for such respect? This type of behavior, where I have money, I can do whatever I want. I am respected, I can do what I want. I am the president of this board and that board, this organization, that organization. In my country, I am disrespected. In my village, I am disrespected. This leads to a person's downfall. This is what happened to Fir'aun. Everything was fine until all of that got to Fir'aun's head. If wealth and respect and power and might, if any of these were worth even a mosquito's wing in the eyes of Allah, Allah would never give it to Fir'aun. Allah would have given it to Bilal. Allah would have given it to Abu Dharr. Allah would have given it to Khabbab. Allah would have given it to these Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. These Sahaba who deserve this, but they're not worth anything, that's why Allah Ta'ala didn't give it to them. And you have Bilal. You see Fir'aun, his maqam in the people's eyes was very high. In this dunya, his maqam, his rank was very high. People looked up to Fir'aun, that we wish we could be like him. So his maqam in the eyes of the people in this dunya was very high. But his maqam in the eyes of Allah was so low, that as I'm speaking, this very second, he is being punished. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, النَّارُ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَيْهَا غُدُوًا وَعَشِيًّا. That upon Fir'aun and his people, they are tasting the fire of Jahannam morning and evening. And Bilal radiallahu anhu, for an example, Bilal, the muadhin of the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was a slave from Abyssinia. He was the son of a mother who was also a slave. Bilal radiallahu anhu used to be beat in the streets of Makkah just for saying La ilaha illallah. He would be beat. They would drag him around the streets of Makkah and beat him so that he could give up saying the kalima. And he still did not. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu saw him going through so much torture and finally freed him. And his story goes on and on. He was not from a very wealthy family. His maqam in this dunya was not very high. People did not wish to be like Bilal in regards to dunya. But what was his maqam in the eyes of Allah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day came to Bilal and said, Oh Bilal, last night in my dream, I heard your footsteps in Jannah ahead of me. This was his maqam in the eyes of Allah. It's not about what your maqam is in people's eyes. People will praise you one day. By morning, people will praise you. By evening, they'll be talking bad about you. This is how it works. We must be concerned about our maqam in the eyes of Allah. Khair, why did we go through this whole incident? When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw that the Jews, they are fasting on a particular day. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the Jews, what is this fast you are doing today? So the Yahud said that, O Muhammad, we fast this day because this is the day that Allah saved Prophet Musa from Fir'aun and his army. And Prophet Musa used to fast that day each year, thanking Allah for saving him. So we are also fasting, thanking Allah for saving Prophet Musa. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam heard this, then he said that we are more rightful of doing this ibadah than. So he asked us, his ummah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked us that we fast on this day also. And that day is the 10th of Muharram. That's this Sunday, inshallah. Now, it's best that a person fast on the 9th and the 10th and the 11th of Muharram. Okay, so that would be Saturday, this coming. Saturday, Sunday, Monday. If you cannot fast these 3 days, then the 9th and the 10th. Right, so Saturday and Sunday. And if you cannot fast even these 2 days, then just fast on the 10th of Muharram itself. The Prophet ﷺ said that fasting on this day of Muharram, the 10th of Muharram, Allah Ta'ala will forgive the person's sins for the previous year. So let us all try to wake up for suhoor inshallah and fast. And just one request to everyone, try to come a little earlier for the khutbah, because a lot of the times there are important points that I can only bring in the beginning of the lecture and a lot of you may miss out. I usually try to bring the important things in the end. Important meaning where I ask you to do this or I ask you to learn this. But sometimes I have to bring it in the beginning. So try to come earlier so you don't miss anything. And of course it's more rewarding for you. May Allah Ta'ala make us humble servants of His. Ameen. May Allah Ta'ala be with us in our times of need as Allah Ta'ala was there for Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Ameen. Barakallahu lana wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ana wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikril hakim. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'il muslimin fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafur rahim. Alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlilhu fala hadiya lahu. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعص الله ورسوله فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين خصوصا على أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن بقية ستة من العشرة المبشرة وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بعفوك وجودك وكرمك وإحسانك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم كن لنا ولا تكن علينا اللهم ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم واحد صفوف المسلمين وجمع كلمة المسلمين على الحق يا رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.